morning, my dear brethren. May the Lord bless you. Welcome to today's devotional. We're going to go to the second book of Samuel, concretely in chapter 7, as of verse 8 on. The word of the Lord says, pay attention. Now therefore, thus shall you say to my servant David, thus says the Lord of hosts, I took you from the sheepfold, from following the sheep, to be ruler over my people, over Israel. And I have been with you wherever you have gone, and have cut off all your enemies from before you, and have made you a great name, like the name of the great men who are on the earth. Moreover, I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them, that they may dwell in a place in their own, and move no more, nor shall the sons of wickedness oppress them any more, as previously. Since the time that I command the judges to be over my people Israel, and have caused you to rest from all your enemies, also the Lord tells you that he will make you a house. And verse 12 says, and when your days are fulfilled and you rest with your fathers, I will set up your seed after you, who will come from your body, and I will establish his kingdom. What an incredible promises the Lord is making to his servant David. The promises of God are a gift, are a wonderful gift, because we see in them, and each one of them, the desire that our good Lord has to bless us and give us permanent peace. He's assuring his present and his future. So if he believes in those promises that God is making with him, he will be able to sleep well and rest in peace. Even if David had a lot of enemies inside or outside his home, God promises him that he will be with him, that he will give him stability, that he will have descendants and continuity of his kingdom. Now, there is a detail that is very important if you have paid attention to the reading that I have shared with you today. And that is that God says, I took you from the sheepfold so that you will be prince over my people. Why is he reminding him from where he came from to convert him into the most important man of the nation? So that David will never forget his past. So that he will not lose the humbleness, so the humility, so that he will always have his foot on ground. And that is something very important that you that never have to go from your life, humility. Not be tortured by the past or living the past. I'm not referring to that. But always to have present that our God was the one who had mercy of us in a certain time of our lives. And he took us to the place where we are in the moment. In other words, it is the best way, the best antidote against a pride, against arrogance, to believe that we are superior to other people because of the blessings, because of how God has used for the doors that have been opened, etc. Yes, David was loved and popular man, and he was also the king of Israel, and he conquered and all the enemies, but never he has to forget his origin, a shepherd of sheep, a very good one, and faithfulness to those sheep. He was willing to risk his life when there was a lion, when there was a bear, but a simple shepherd of sheep. But for the grace of God, and because God put his gaze in him and selected him to be the king of Israel, David would have been just a regular shepherd among a lot of them. Therefore, number one, do not ever lose the perspective of your life. Do not forget what you were before you came to know the Lord. And thank to him, not to our merits or our actions or our works or our charisma, but because of the glory and the mercy of the Lord, these jars of clay, instruments, temporary instruments in the hands of God, can see the glory of God and be used by him during the time that he considers possible. In second place, I see that Like David was promised not only a present during his kingdom and as a king, but also for his descendants. And there is a detail that calls my attention. That is that God is showing in some way that there is not nobody that is needed. He's an important king. He's an influential king, but one day he will go with his fathers and he will be buried like any mortal man. And like today, we can, after so many years, visit the tomb of King David. He's already dead and his glory has gone. And then Solomon raised up and then another and another king. Nobody is needed. No, there is nobody, no pastor, no evangelist, no teacher, no singer, nobody is needed and is essential in the church, in the kingdom of God. The only one that is needed and essential is by of the presence of the person of our Lord Jesus Christ, with all that entails. The Lord promises him that he will take care of him from his enemies, and there were a lot. And during practically all his life, he was fighting. Even though when he was older, his soldiers and generals, they asked him to stay in the palace because he had done everything that he should have done. And they didn't have to go to the battlefield to continue risking his life. But what is clear is that he was always courageous. But in spite of that, and in a good soldier that he was, like one of the Psalms, Jehovah does not build the house, it is in vain. If the Lord does not build the house, they labor in vain who build it. All our efforts, all our work, all our eloquency, all our things we can do are in vain. If we do not enjoy from the backing and the support of God, if the Lord does not support what we do, it is in vain. Because as I have said in many occasions, and I repeat today, God does not need us absolutely for anything. Before the world existed, before the human race existed, he was already God, and he will continue to be God for eternity. We are the ones who need him, and not he that needs us. To be more God or more powerful or more recognized worldwide. There is something also that calls my attention in this passage, and that is how God tells him that he will go, he will be buried with his fathers. He will not die young. That when the time comes, one of the characteristics of the believer is that he does not afraid of death, because the death is not the end of something, it's the beginning of something, and a better thing than the earthly life that we have during so many years in this earth. So therefore, the fear, the insecurity, the worriness for death, for the enemies, for the economy, for our health, disappears in the face of the precious sight that we have ahead of us, because not only our Lord makes a promise to King David that you and I and each one of us, God is giving us hundreds and thousands of promises, promises that are going to be fulfilled, promises that are being fulfilled, promises that are going to help us to feed our faith and to stay firm and faithfulness to God. Promises that are assuring us that the Lord will never leave us or forsake us, that he will be with us in any country that we are. Because there are many of you that have had to leave their own countries to find work or security or whatever it may. But even if you are out of your country, God is with you. He has not left you behind. You have not left him behind. Even if you're older or you're starting your ministry, the Lord will always be by your side, taking care of you, blessing and helping you. Your present and your future are in the hands of the Lord. We do not have to be afraid of anyone or anything. It's not that we don't believe in doctors and in science, but there are some simply opinions. There are comments. It is an opinion of a man, but the last word is always be the Lord's. That's why we don't have to be afraid of the diagnostic that have been received. We don't have to be afraid of that test, that result, because the last word is always the Lord's. And the Lord can change everything from night to morning, if it is His will. Maybe you're not that young anymore and you don't have the strength and the energy. Maybe the enthusiasm that you had when you were young, but it doesn't matter. God doesn't age. He doesn't expire. He doesn't abandon you in a certain moment of your life, but He will be with you all, every day of our lives until the end of the earth. So therefore, my dear brethren, the best antidote, the best medicine, if I may say, for to conquer fear and depression and sadness are the promises of God. It is our God that is living in our hearts permanently. David ended his life with the blessing of God. He went to history as an incredible man of God. Until the day of today, we respect him and we recognize him, but his days are over and he's not with us anymore. But there is a king that he never expires, that he will always be with us, and he is our Lord Jesus Christ. And that's why to that King of Kings and Lord of Lords, we pray and we worship and we honor and we serve with our lives every day, because we know that his kingdom is everlasting, and he will reign for the in house of Jacob forever, as the word of God says. Therefore, my dear brethren and friends, on top of David, and which we appreciate, is our king that is alive in this moment, in this time by our side, and we submit and we put under his coverage so that he will once again protect us, take care of us, help us, and we can be instruments in his hands if that is his will, and we believe that that is his will to use our lives. Let's pray to the Lord this morning with all the faith and trust that we have, knowing that he is attentive right now to the cry of hundreds and hundreds of brothers and sisters that are going to be together in prayer, asking for the blessing of God over our lives, over our congregations, and over all the things that we're going to do for him today. Blessed be your name. We give you thanks to you. We give you honor and glory. Thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. Thank you for remembering us every day, for using our lives, for the fruit that we have been able to see as a result of the work of years. Thank you, Lord, because you are the one who prosper us and bless your beloved church. Continue blessing our lives and continue using us. Protect us from all evil and all the enemies, like you guarded David. Take care of our enemies spiritually that exist and are real, but that you are more powerful than them because of you, your name. We ask you for all our brothers that are in the ministry making an effort to preach the good news of the gospel. Give them a renewal of the ones that are sad and or tired, or they're discouraged by so much work. Bless us this day, that your glory will be poured over your beloved church. Lord, and we give you thanks because you have remembered us and you have put us in a place of privilege and you have given us an honor to serve you. Lord, we put our lives in your hands and we give you thanks in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. My dear brethren, it is a pleasure as always being with you every morning. I know that many make an effort to be able to get up or to stay awake to listen to the devotional every day. May the Lord bless us, Lord. May the Lord use us. May we have the assurance and the peace constantly from the Lord every day in our hearts, so that we know that as he was with his servant David, he will be with us every day of our lives. My dear brethren, may the Lord bless you. May you have a day of peace, of blessing, in the name of Jesus. Amen.